Hey guys, welcome back and welcome if you're new. Today we're going to look at how to open up an account with ETRADE. If you're new to the channel, be sure to subscribe and let's go ahead and get started.
We're going to go ahead and open up the ETRADE site. If you've never opened up a brokerage account before, this can be helpful just to see what information they ask for. It's pretty similar across any company that you do it through. They're going to ask for the same information. So let's go ahead and start going through that now. The first page that you're going to come to is going to ask you what type of account you actually want to open. If you don't see the account type that you want here, I'll also link to ETRADE's page down below where they list out every single account type because there are other options other than what they list here. But going through this main screen, we're going to see brokerage account, bank account, or retirement account. If you're wanting to actually open up a brokerage account to buy stocks, that's going to be that brokerage account or that retirement account option. And again, I'll leave the link to their full list in the description. I'm going to select brokerage account, and on the next screen, we'll get a few more options. Individual, joint, or custodial account. So super quick explanation of these. Individual would just be you. Joint account would be if you have a spouse or someone that you're sharing the account with. And custodial account would be if you're opening it for your kid that is under 18. The next page asks if we are an existing customer. Likely the answer is no, but if you do already have an account open with them or a retirement account open with them, you can actually log into your existing account and continue from there. And that just makes the process a little bit quicker. The next page is going to ask for our basic contact information. So our full name, our phone number, and an email address where we want to receive all communications about our ETRADE account. So if you lose your password, that's going to be the email that you check. If you want to know when your statements have come in and things like that, that's going to be the email that you want to use, is where you want to receive that. And continuing on, the next page is just going to be your address. And if your mailing address is different from your residential address, you'll click that box at the bottom, that little checkbox, and you'll be able to enter a separate address if your mailing address is actually different. The next page is going to start the identity verification process. This is going to be the same across any brokerage that you try to sign up for. They all ask the same information, sometimes in a different order, but it is information that you do have to provide them. So they're going to ask for things like your social security number, like your employment status, who you're employed by, how much you make, your net worth, and we'll get to all those screens in a second. But that is a general overview of the type of information that they are going to ask you for. I will leave a link in the description to a government article explaining why they're required to collect that information if you are interested in reading more about that, but we're going to go ahead and fill this out. So we'll start with birthday, social security number, and on the next page, this is where they ask for that employment information. So they'll ask you what your occupation is and then more information about the company that you actually work for. There are options for if you're self-employed or anything like that. Those are options that you can select from as well, but you will still have to provide them with all of that information. On the next page, they're going to start asking you information about why you're investing, how much money you have, what your net worth is. So the first question on this page is, what's the investment objective of this account? So why are you investing? What are you intending to invest in? What types of stocks or securities? So you'll see on this dropdown that it says speculation. That's going to be those higher risk stocks that move up and down in price point a lot. They're generally considered riskier. That's what they mean by speculation. Growth would be you're trying to grow that account. So this would likely be stocks that you're trying to hold on to longer term. Next, we have income. So maybe if you're just using this account to try to make extra money in the stock market, or if you're a dividend investor and you are trying to earn extra money from those dividends that you earn. And capital preservation kind of just means that you're putting your money in this account because maybe you don't want to put it in a savings account and you're just kind of using it to preserve the capital that you have. Next, it's going to ask you questions about your income and your net worth, your liquid net worth. And if you're not sure what these mean when you're selecting them, they do have those little eye icons that are next to the entry fields where you can hover over it and see what they are actually asking for in each of those sections. So do read through those if you are not sure. They'll ask you for your investing experience. So if you've never invested, if you think you're pretty good at investing, if you're an expert, it'll ask you that. It'll also ask you some more basic information like your marital status and if you have any dependents. If you are wanting to have any special features on your account, like access to options trading or margin trading, which is borrowing money, or if you want to trade futures, you can select those options from this page. And if you select any of those options, there may be a few additional questions that they have you fill out. But if those are things that you do want to have on your account, this is the page where you will select those. If you're not sure what those are, they do have the little eye icons next to these fields again, explaining exactly what these options do. So assuming that you filled this out, we're going to go ahead and press continue. Then we arrive at the regulatory questions page, which again are questions that every single brokerage is required to ask. Again, I'll have the link to that government article explaining why in the description, but it's basically to make sure that you don't have any insider trading information, that you aren't somehow linked to a public company in some sketchy way, and that you aren't doing anything weird with your money because of certain connections that you have with different people or companies or things like that. Assuming that you aren't associated with any of these things, for this tutorial, we're going to select no on all of these and press continue. This next page is asking us more information about where the money is coming from that we're actually funding this account with and how we intend to actually use this account. So that first question, all it's asking is, where is your money coming from? For a lot of people, this may be just that first employment income option where you're using the money that you're earning from work to invest. But if you did get the money to invest as a gift, or if it was money that you already had in savings and now you're just investing it, those options are listed on that big dropdown as well. The second question is going to ask you how you intend to actually use this account. So are you a day trader? Are you just learning how to invest? Are you investing for retirement? All of those options, again, are on this dropdown that they provide you. The next page is going to ask you where you want to keep money that isn't invested. If you click on that purple compare options link above these two options, that will explain this further to you, but it's basically, where do you want that money that isn't actually invested in a stock or ETF or whatever you're investing in? Where do you want that money to go? So you'll select one of these options. If you have a person, like maybe a parent or a child or someone else that you want to add as a trusted point of contact regarding your account, that is where you would select that yes or no option, and you can enter their information from there. And then if you have any sort of promotional code, this is also the page where you can enter those. And the last page is where you'll review all of their agreements, their terms of service, their disclosures, privacy policies, etc. So once you read through those, and if you agree, you'll check those little check boxes, click continue, and this next page is going to ask us to create a user ID. So this is going to be your username and your password that you log on to ETRADE with every time, so make sure that it's something that you remember. After you get past this page and you actually have created your account and your user ID, you'll then have the option to go ahead and fund your account, or you can skip that step and fund it later. If you have any questions with this, always reach out to the brokerage that you're using directly, to their customer service. And of course, they usually provide extra information and guidance. If you scroll down to the bottom, they'll provide you with their different terms and articles and everything there.
If this video was helpful, be sure to subscribe, follow us on Instagram, and I'll see you guys next time.